Here is another example of submit button. In this app, and the user can choose the choice of dataset from this list, and this is basically the select input widget. We also have provision to select the number of observations, so the user can see n number of observations from that dataset. And by default, here we have iris dataset as the dataset, and number of observations are 6. In the main panel, we will see the structure of iris dataset here. And first 6 observation, because 6 is by default, and we will see 6 observations of first 6 observation of iris dataset here. So how does submit button work here? So in case I want to see empty cars dataset, and I want to see first 10 observations, you see that as I change the input, the main panel output doesn't change, and that's because we have the submit button here. If I click on this button, which says the label as update, there we see the change in the main panel, and we now see the structure of empty cars dataset as well as first 10 observation of empty cars versus what we saw earlier, the iris dataset structure as well as observations. So let's go back to RStudio and have a glance of UI.R and server.R to see how submit button is used. Okay, so in the UI.R, the first thing we have is library Shiny, and we are loading the Shiny package. Then we have Shiny UI, which is function which is telling R that we are in the UI.R, or this is the basically the user interface. We have fluid page. Then we have inside fluid page the two components, title panel, and we'll see the main panel down here. Title panel, we are just printing demonstration of submit button, which we see in the app here, demonstration of submit button. We then have in the sidebar panel the two widgets, the select input and the numeric input widget. And here we just followed the syntax of select input, the input ID, the label, and the choices using the C function, iris, pressure, and empty cars dataset. Then we also have another numeric input widget where the input ID is OBS observation, number of observations, and the value 6, which is by default and could be increased based on the user's choice. Then this update button is basically from the submit button here. If we see line number 16, submit button, and the label is update. This is what is doing the magic of controlling the reactivity. As soon as R sees the submit button, it knows that okay, the output should not be changed immediately after change in input. Instead, it should wait for the submit button clicked. We then have these statements which we have printed here in this example, changing the user input, dataset or number of observations, blah, blah, blah. Submit button is used to control the reactiveness of the change in user input. Then going further, we have the main panel. Let me reload the app real quick. In the main panel, we see the text output here, and that is just the heading showing, text output showing the name of the data set, and we are also saying using the verbatim output, we are displaying the structure, and both the data name as well as structure is coming from server.r, which we'll see in a couple of minutes. We also have another text output which is a heading for displaying observations, first n observations for whatever data set is chosen by the by the user, and we are also displaying the first n observations in table output using the output ID view. Again, the output ID view and observation is coming from server.r, which we'll see in a couple of minutes. So pretty simple. It's just we have followed this basic skeleton of UI.r, putting the widgets, and in the main panel we are trying to display the output using the output functions. Let's go to server.r and see what is going on there. In the server.r, we see the first thing we have is we are loading the Shiny package, datasets package. Shiny server is telling R that we are in the server .r, or this is the server scripting or the server programming. We have this function. Within this we have render functions. The first one is render text, and we are using this to have the heading structure of the data set, followed by whatever user has chosen, and this is coming basically from the UI.r. So say user has chosen iris or pressure or empty cars data set, it will get stored in data set input ID, which is used here in server.r. So the sentence would become structure of the data set, say empty cars, structure of data set pressure, or structure of data set iris, and this whatever is the final outcome of this paste function gets stored in data name, output ID or output variable, which is then used in our main panel here using text output data name. And this is how we see the heading here, structure of dataset iris. And if I choose pressure, it will be structure of dataset pressure. And we have another heading here, which we are going to see next in the server.r. Let's go back to server.r, and we have another render text state function here, and we are using the paste function to create this entire statement or sentence. Say first n, right, that is n or whatever is that value, input dollar obs. Obs is the input ID, which is storing the value entered by the user, the number of observations. By default it is 6, and whatever value is chosen by the user, it gets stored in obs. So first n, or say first 6 observations of the data set, input dollar data set, which data set, this is the data set chosen by the user. So it will be first n, say 6 observations of the data set iris. And the output of this the final outcome of this paste function or the sentence gets stored in the output variable or output ID observation, and we are using that in the main panel here, this text output function observation. And that's how we see first 6 observations of the data set iris. Next we have another render statement here, render print, and this is to print the structure. So first of all we need to get the structure, and we get that by using the str function in R, and str function on the data set chosen by the user. And so we have used get function here. Always remember that the output of the format or the class type of the input ID from the input select input widget is a character type. So in order to get the absolute value, we use get statement. So get input dollar data set will give us the absolute value, not the character class type, the actual data or the actual value. So in this case it would be by default, since by default the data set is iris, it will be str iris. And so whatever is the outcome of str function on iris gets stored in the output variable or output ID structure, which we use in the main panel. here using verbatim text output because we want to format it in that way, verbatim format. Next we have the last render function, render table, and in this we are displaying the first n observations of the data set selected by the user, and we do that by using the head function in R. Head function on the data set, comma, the number of observations we need. So if we had to do this in R, we would have said head iris, comma, 6. So again, this is coming from get function on input dollar data set. So absolute value of the data set which is chosen by the user. By default, it was iris. It may be empty cars or pressure. And input dollar ops is again coming from the numeric input widget, the OBS input ID. And finally, the outcome or the first n observations are stored in view output ID or output variable and used in our main panel here, table output. Since we are using the table render table, we have to use table output, and we are using table output to display that. So again, it's all the widgets and how we are processing in server.r, but the key here is submit button. The reason I showed this example is also to show how we can display the first n observations and structure along with submit button, so we can get an idea.